On Monday, March 13th, 2019, NASA declared, "We are going to the moon to stay by 2024. It's an exciting announcement, the return to a place humans haven't set foot on in more than 45 years. A serious goal that will test the ability of technology and engineering, as well as the bravery of the men and women who will carry out this task. But we've also heard announcements like this before, many times. How will the mission come together? What are the risks? What's new this time? The White House has been working on its plans to send humans to the moon for several months now, pushed forward by U.S. Vice President Mike Pence and NASA's new administrator, Jim Bridenstine. The original plan was to send crewed missions to the moon by 2028. And then several weeks ago, the target date of 2024 was floated, and it was met by skepticism, concern, a little excitement. Returning to the moon would be amazing, a serious goal, and the next step in becoming a spacefaring civilization. But we've heard sweeping goals like this before. We're going to Mars. We're going back to the moon. We're sending humans to an asteroid. We're building a space station out by the moon. And now humans to the moon by 2024. Now, one of the reasons for the 2024 deadline is to minimize the chance that a new White House administration would switch goals. Okay, what's the plan? The name for NASA's new program is Project Artemis, named after the Greek goddess and twin sister of Apollo. Also, the name of Andy Weir's new book about a city on the moon. Coincidence? This new program works with most of the existing hardware that's currently under construction by NASA, but shuffles the schedule around a bit. The original strategy was to first construct the gateway in lunar space using the enormous Space Launch System. Future missions would carry humans in the Orion spacecraft to the gateway, which they could then use as a platform for sending astronauts down to the surface. Under the strategy, the first astronaut would set foot on the moon in 2028. The new Artemis plan pushes the construction of the gateway back several years, building one core module by 2022, and then using this as the stepping stone back to the moon by 2024. So here's the new schedule. Over the course of 2019, NASA is going to partner with 9 US companies to deliver payloads to the moon. As early as this year, the first missions could start sending new science instruments and technologies to the lunar surface. These commercial partnerships will continue over the years as NASA continues its lunar exploration beyond 2024. In 2020, NASA's Exploration Mission 1 will launch. This will be an uncrewed flight of the Space Launch System carrying an Orion spacecraft into an orbit near the moon. Then, in 2022, will be Exploration Mission 2, another launch of the Space Launch System, carrying astronauts on a mission around the moon for the first time in over 50 years. Later in 2022, a commercial partner like United Launch Alliance, SpaceX, or Blue Origin will launch the first module for the Gateway, the power and propulsion element. It'll have a solar electric propulsion system and provide power and communications for the astronauts. In 2023, a rover will be sent to the lunar pole to search for water ice mixed into the regolith at the moon's permanently shadowed craters. This will provide more information so that future astronauts will be able to live off the land, turning water ice into rocket fuel, air to breathe, and water to drink. Finally, in 2024, on the third launch of the Space Launch System, humans will return to the moon. They'll stop in at the gateway and then take a lunar lander down to the surface near the moon's south pole. Over the next few years, astronauts will continue with additional missions to the moon, building up capabilities to attempt missions to Mars by the 2030s. Are they serious? Is this actually going to happen? I'll talk about that in a second, but first I'd like to thank Thomas Cherisolis, O212, and the rest of our 794 patrons for the generous support. They contribute so that you can see these videos and we can make them freely available to anyone who wants to learn about space. Join our community at patreon.com/universetoday and get in on the action. This week, NASA Administrator Jim Bridenstine said that NASA was going to need an additional $1.6 $1 billion in funding this year if it'll have any chance of reaching the moon by 2024. Not only that, but this amount was just a down payment to catch up development to that deadline, and that it would need even more funding in the coming years to reach that deadline. This additional budget would set aside $1 billion for the Human Lunar Landing System. NASA will purchase a commercial lander that can transport astronauts from the Gateway to the surface of the moon and back. Blue Origin's Jeff Bezos coincidentally presented the Blue Moon Strategy this week, building a landing system that could put tons of hardware onto the surface of the moon. And with an enhanced propulsion system, it could even support a crewed lander. It looks like you just got your first customer, Jeff. It calls for an additional $651 million for the Space Launch System and Orion spacecraft to adapt their development to the new plan. An additional $132 million in exploration technologies like the Gateway's solar electric propulsion system and methods of converting lunar ice into water. And $90 million for more scientific exploration of the surface of the moon's polar regions. This means the president's total budget request for NASA will be $22.6 billion in fiscal year 2020, about $1 billion more than Congress approved for 2019. This is a seriously big budget. But is it enough? According to Casey Dreyer from the Planetary Society, he and other aerospace engineers estimated that NASA would probably need $4 to $5 billion in additional funding every year to reach that 2024 deadline. If there's one thing we've seen, pushing the limits of space exploration costs money and budgets run high. The Space Launch System is already billions of dollars over budget and wasn't specifically designed with lunar landings in mind. The Office of the Inspector General made a detailed investigation and has estimated that Boeing is expected to spend $8.9 billion on SLS through 2021, and delivery of the core stage has already slipped 2.5 years. What about commercial partners? SpaceX just successfully launched the Falcon Heavy for the second time, with more launches coming soon. So it does look like there are rockets that could assist the Space Launch System in sending the hardware into lunar orbit and down to the surface of the moon. Well, now you know the plan and some of the constraints. Is it going to happen? Obviously, we have no idea. Experience tells us that space exploration takes longer and costs more than anyone expects. A lot more. I think we'll know pretty quickly if the White House and Congress are serious about this plan, if we see the budget increase to match the demands for this faster timetable. But if the budgets don't happen, if construction on the Space Launch System stalls, if the commercial partners aren't ready with their hardware, if safety gets compromised in any way, we'll see the timeline slip. This will be new White House administrations, changing plans, changing priorities, and maybe changing destinations. It's what always happens. What do you think? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Once a week, I gather up all my space news into a single email newsletter and send it out. It's got pictures, brief highlights about the story, and links so that you can find out more. Go to universetoday.com/newsletter to sign up. And did you know that all of my videos are also available in a handy audio podcast format so that you can have the latest episodes show up right on your audio device? Go to universetoday.com/audio or search for Universe Today on iTunes, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts, and I'll put a link in the show notes. And finally, here's a playlist.